Yep, that's right. The Japanese have a new dev blog already, only a few days after the release of 1.65. Now, the reason that they're doing a dev blog on this is obviously they've had some vehicles on the basically kind of in the background that they've been waiting to announce. This is going to be a premium vehicle, so keep that in mind. I was surprised to see a dev blog this soon, but once I heard that it was a premium vehicle, it was kind of expected and not too surprising. So I can't really say, although I want to see like heavy tank Japanese dev blog or something like that, this is expected, and the Japanese definitely do need premiums on their tech tree. So I'm all for it. I don't have much time again, so what I'm going to be talking about on this is the Type 3 Chinoo 2, which is basically, well, it's a beefed up version essentially of the Chinoo, which is available on the standard tech tree. So let's see what is different from this thing. So basically, the overall difference is that it says all of these changes had a single goal in mind, which was to mount the Type 5 75 mm cannon onto the tank. Did it? Well, it did. It was designed with a Type 3 75 mm cannon, as it says here, derived from the dated Type 90 field artillery. While it provided sufficient against armored targets such as the M4 Sherman, it was barely acceptable and needed to be replaced, so it makes a perfect premium. At the time, tanks such as the Chi. Well, history shit. But essentially, the 75 mm is pretty good for the Japanese. Especially as it says down here. So it says, in War Thunder, players will be very familiar with the Chinoo 2 after experiencing the Chinoo in the research tree. The armor is thin, staying the same as the Chinoo. However, unlike the standard tank, the premium one is given the Type 5 75 mm gun. This gun is exceedingly deadly in the field. Continuing the Japanese custom of giving armor-piercing shells a large explosive filler, this can give any unsuspecting target a nasty surprise with its great post-penetration explosive effect. It says here that the strategy for using this deadly tank in combat is to be stealthy. In order to use the benefit of having such a powerful cannon, you should support teammates from the rear by using the gun's accuracy and deadly armor-piercing high-explosive shells to be the best ability, or to the best ability. The tank has fairly decent mobility, which will allow players to perform flanking maneuvers in combat. An electric turret traversing gear adapted from the Chinoo also allows the rapid target or for a rapid targeting. Players will find this feature helpful as many low-tier tanks have slow manually traverse turrets. Here we go. So it's going to be a tier 3 premium for the Japanese tech tree. It doesn't say how much it's going to cost, and it's probably going to be out within the next couple weeks, I'd assume, or very maybe even sooner. So already we've got fucking premiums being added to the game. But the Japanese do need more premiums, and although it's not a tier 4 premium like I was hoping for, it's something at least, and I am quite excited to see it in battle. I'm very excited to play some more of the Japanese tanks. I'm just taking a break right now. But hey, you know what? I don't have to take a break from the Japanese tech tree altogether. I could play lower tier, but just grind modifications on some of the Japanese tanks to get used to how they work. We'll see. I don't know if things have calmed down in realistic battles or not yet, but that's where I wanted to spend my time when reaching elite status with vehicles. But for right now, guys, like I said, this is going to have to be a shorter video. It's not much to add on. It's basically just an already existing tank in the game, but with a different gun. Pretty much a better gun, or a beefier gun, depending on your tastes in combat. Tier 3 premium. Have your wallets ready if you want to pick this thing up. Unfortunately, you won't be able to get it in the sale, but it'll be a thing for future purchases. Not sure if I'll be purchasing it right away. Don't know if I'll have enough, but we'll see. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next War Thunder upcoming content video.